The Demco 8020.5 is already a more affordable version of the Demco 8020, which is made in the US. It's a much larger knife and such. There's a lot of pins on this guy, so at least 1, 2, 3 different pins kind of holding it together right there, right? So only screws are used towards the back on the handle. And based on my scale, I want to say maybe 3.9, right? 3.94 ounces on the 8020.5. Here we go. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Miguel and you're watching Miguel EDC, where we talk everything EDC gear here. Today we're going to be reviewing the Demco 8020.5, this beauty right here, especially this one with the shark's foot. This is the shark's foot blade variation. There's also a clip point version as well, but we're going to be focusing mainly today on the shark's foot blade here. And I mean, there's so much to tell you about this knife, so much that I can't wait to unpack with you guys. Talking about this guy, did an unboxing on this knife not that long ago, about a month or two ago, and I've had the opportunity to EDC this guy like crazy. This knife has not left my pocket for so long, and I can't wait to share with you guys what the experience is all about. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it here. So we got multiple deployment options with this guy. We of course have the infamous shark lock. That is one of the main things about this knife that you won't find in many other knives. It is the locking mechanism right here. So of course you could swing it open like that with a flick of the wrist. You of course have the thumb deployment right there. You could always open it like that if you want, and you could reverse flick like that, which is my favorite. Of course, you guys already know, if you watch some of my videos, you know that reverse flick action is always going to be my most favorite one. Of course, you have this opening right here, so I guess you could sort of do that opening that way as well. It's a little bit more tricky, requires a little bit more of a swing if you want to open it using that opening area there on the blade. Of course, we have the shark's foot, which is a very worn cliff looking blade style right here. We're gonna get into that. Let's get some quick measurements here. Let's get that out of the way really quick. Let's get an overall length on this guy. So it comes in right at, let's see. All right, total length is gonna be 7.5, just a little bit shy of 7.5 inches. The total blade there is gonna be 3 inches and, you know, maybe 1/8 or so. The actual cutting edge is gonna be 2.75 or 2 inches and 3/4 right there. And the handle is going to be around, let's see where we got total handle. It's going to be around 4 3/8 of an inch. Let's talk materials on this guy. So we have a stonewashed OS 10A blade. Again, keep in mind this one is the around $160 or so entry point. The Demco 8020.5 is already a more affordable version of the Demco 8020, which is made in the US. It's a much larger knife and such, but this one is made overseas in Taiwan. It's the most affordable variant of the Demco 8020.5 is this entry point here with the OS 10 blade, OS 10A, if you want to be very, very exact. Let me get a zoom in right there. All right, there it is. Of course, you got the Demco logo on this side. And then as far as the handle, this is FRN. So you got this FRN gray, grivery FRN looking handle. You don't get the premium Demco knives pivot screw right here and things like that. So you kind of forego some of the nice aspects of the more premium version with this entry point version. The, you know, one pin PA is all actually printed in the FRN versus the actual, versus it actually being a pivot screw. Of course, there are more expensive versions that have that good looking screw right there, but not this guy at this price point. Do have the 8020.5 also printed on there. This blade handle has a design here very similar to the titanium version of this knife, which is around $375, almost $400. With both blades, you do have the ability to choke forward if you wanted to. You do want to be very, very careful though with the beginning of the blade edge right there, right? But you could forward choke if you wanted to. Check it out here on the clip point as well. You could do that, of course, especially if you put your thumb here on the jib pin. That's going to have you more control of the blade at all times. But yeah, this guy, believe it or not, is milled, so that helps with the weight quite a bit. And also, I know a lot of people are very skeptical because of the grivery and such, right? Thinking it's gonna be flimsy, thinking it's gonna be a weak knife, a weak structure, what have you. But guys, those are stainless steel liners right there, so it really adds a lot of rigidity to the knife and makes it very nice and solid. And this pattern right here, this pattern printed into the grivery FRN, that makes it very, very nice and grippy. That is not leaving your hand. And just the whole construction on this guy, it is such a tank. Just the noises of it, right? The acoustics are just wonderful. This guy is in ball bearings. I know probably you guys are probably wondering. So yeah, got ball bearings going on this guy. They help the action be that smooth. Since we're here, let's do a quick hardware check on this guy like we do in every review. By the way, my tools are linked down below in the description. They're part of the Strabito set, and it has every drill bit, you know, a couple of screwdrivers, everything you might need to assemble, disassemble, maintain your knife. Check out those affiliate links down below. They come at no extra cost to you. I want to take a good guess with this guy, and I want to say that's probably T6 all around, which will be sort of a shame because I would have wanted those to be T8, but that looks like it's T6, and the pivot might be a T8 or T10, right? If it's T10, I'll be impressed. Might just be a T8, and that's pretty much it, right? Notice too, there's a lot of pins on this guy. So at least 1, 2, 3 different pins kind of holding it together right there, right? So only screws are used towards the back on the handle. So that pivot screw right there, right, it's actually holding a lot of pressure right there since there are no screws on this, you know, part of the handle. Moment of truth, here we go, T6. Yes, yeah, it was a T6 right there on the handle screws. All right, let's check out the pocket clip. So the pocket clip screws are going to be T6 as well. Let's check T8 on the pivot, and yeah, that is loosey-goosey, so I'm pretty sure it's going to be a T10, which is my original guess right there, and bam, there it is, T10 on the pivot screw. All right, so you got T6 everywhere except T10 on the pivot, and then a couple of pins right there in the mix. My gripe that I do have about the pocket clip is that it is not deep carry. This guy is not deep carry at all, so when you are carrying your knife with the default pocket clip, about that much of your knife is going to show, which is a bit of a shame. I have been researching, trying to look for a good aftermarket pocket clip, just like I did with the Spyderco knives, just to make it a little bit more pocket carry, deep pocket carry than it comes from the factory. I'm still yet to find, right? If you guys have any recommendations, let me know in the comments, but I'm still yet to find a good deep pocket carry alternatives from the Demco 8020.5, or maybe perhaps I haven't looked hard enough. But yeah, so far I'm rocking the stock pocket clip for now. That is my only, probably the only gripe I have with this guy, is how much it sticks out in the pocket. You do have a substantial lanyard hole or lanyard tube right there, so that is quite substantial, as you can clearly see there, so you should have no issues with that whatsoever. Let's do a quick weight on this guy. All right, let's do a quick weight on this guy. I want to get some comparable knives out here. There we go, PM2 Para 3, right? Doesn't get more comparable than that. We'll even have the clip point here to check the weight on that as well. So Para 3 comes in at 3.3 ounces, right? The PM2 comes in at 3.8 ounces, and based on my scale, I want to say maybe 3.9, right? 3.94 ounces on the 8020.5. Here we go. Moment of truth. 3.6 on this guy. Is the clip point any different? Clip point any different? Let's see. All right, the clip point is going to be 3.6 as well. 3.6 on both of them. All right, one last time for fair measure. There it is, right? 3.6 ounces. Blade stock thickness on this guy is going to be, yeah, definitely much less than the 8020. Of course, this is the smaller version. So the stock thickness on this guy is going to be 0.12 inches. Very comparable to the Smok. I want to say the Smok was also 0.12 or 0.11, yeah. There you go, 0.11 on the Smok, whereas let's say the PM2 and Para 3 were 0.14. All right, there you go, some quick comparison right there. That is, of course, on the thickest part, 0.12 inches. On the very, very tip, this one is not necessarily the sliciest of blades, 0.02 inches right there on the very, very tip. I really wish I had the OG 8020 so I could do a nice side-by-side comparison, but just keep in mind, these are a smaller version of the OG 8020, which is a little bit of a much larger knife. This one is right there with the EDC. For everyday carry, the size makes this one a much better candidate than even the OG. The OG 8020 is such a brick, for lack of a better word. It is so, so tough, so thick, right? When it comes to EDC, this guy is going to feel right at home on your jeans, gym shorts, whatever you got going on. It's much more of an EDC-able blade just because of it being a shorter size. One thing I didn't like, in case I haven't mentioned this already, is the printout of the 8020.5. I sort of would have liked just the diamond pattern all throughout without this piece right here. I get why that sort of serves a purpose here for the pocket clip, and when sliding in and out of your pocket, that helps. So there is some functionality to that right there, but I know the OG version 8020 does not have that, so I really wish that wasn't a thing. Even the titanium version doesn't have that either. So that's a small gripe of mine. You know, if that doesn't get in your nerves, then you're absolutely okay and you got nothing to worry about right there. So let me know in the comments if I miss anything. If there's anything additional that you would have liked to have been covered on this review, let me know in the comments. I plan to hang out down there. So any questions that you may happen to have, let me know and I'll be happy to answer those for you. By the time you're watching this video, it's very likely that the Ontario Rat Model 1, the review for this guy, is going to be live on the channel. If that is the case, I'm going to put a card right here for you so you can check out that next. Thank you guys for hanging out with me in this video. You guys are the real MVPs. I'll see you all next time. Take care. Peace.